Hello everyone. If you are someone who recently applied for the Infosys exam and got an information that you are shortlisted for the written exam, then this video is for you. Make sure that you watch this video till the end so that you don't miss any important updates. I'm gonna share you my secret tips which helped me to crack the Infosys exam for you. So keep watching the video. I'm Bhavita and welcome back to my channel. I wrote my exam like this, same as this, which is a cool campus, as I mentioned in my last video last year. So I'll just be sharing you my preparation strategy, like even I prepared in like a few days. As per my last video, I got many comments that like to explain the exam pattern and all. So let me first explain the exam pattern with you all. There is no update that there is a change in the particular pattern. As per whatever I've wrote in last year, or like in the 2025 January, the syllabus would be like this. So your exam, written exam, will be divided into like 7 sections. First section would be reasoning, second section would be quant, third section would be verbal, fourth section would be pseudocode, fifth section would be like some numerical puzzle, and sixth section would be like English grammar test, and seventh section would be like in some English written test. So as per whatever I observed last time, there was no section wise timer. Instead, they will allow us like 120 minutes. For us, it was it started at 11 a.m. and it continued till 1 p.m. So it might be same for you too. And coming to each section, like let's say the first section, reasoning. In this particular section, you will be having the questions which are actually based on reasoning. Like you will be given some statement, and like there will be some options like hypothesis and all. You need to select the appropriate option which is actually compatible with that particular question. Like here, like these kind of questions, you will have like 15 questions, like each carrying 1 mark, which are like 15 marks. And coming to the second section here, like this is something related to the math. Okay, if you're good at math, you can just like start the exam with this particular session. And I'll just give you the tips like where to start and where to start after this particular explanation. So keep watching. So in this section, we do have like 10 questions, each carrying 1 mark again. And next one would be the verbal. Here you will be carrying the most of the marks, like you will be having 20 questions which carries one each, and like which are 20 marks. And then you have a pseudocode. Here there will be asking one or two questions. Even if you don't know code, it's nothing like coding. You just need to apply the logic. You need to understand the statement, whatever they have given, and you need to apply the logic. You can just write it in a step-by-step process, like a step-by-step, like in theoretical way. Or if you know some code, you can write that pseudocode too. That's okay. Anyways, it worked. And then there comes a numerical test puzzle. So here the questions, will be asked based on some puzzles, like different puzzles like shown in here. It would be kind of tricky. So there are videos on YouTube, like, regarding like what kind of questions you will get in this particular section, to watch them too. And there comes the English grammar test. Here, this would be the easiest one if you know English very well. You just need to learn some tenses, articles, like where to use like articles, like where we'll be using the which tense word. And we have subject to predicate, like those agreements. You just need to learn them too. And most probably you will be asked vocabulary too, like synonyms, antonyms, or vocabulary. So mainly it would be actually a good opportunity for you to score higher, because I feel like this is the easiest section overall. And then you will have some English written test. I don't remember what they asked for, but I've written the cooking of chicken biryani, cooking, like how I do it, how I like it, and how I do it. I just written a passage around it. So they ask us to write some article. That's it. They'll be giving you the topic. And coming to the difficulty of the questions, usually if you are prepared well, then it's not at all hard. I say you literally, I just like prepared for like 4 to 5 days, which actually made me clear the exam. And even after I wrote the exam, I was like damn sure that I would be clearing that. So the first thing first, you should prepare. Okay, so you should mainly focus on aptitude, you have the logical aptitude and mental aptitude, you just need to focus on both of these. And if you have some logical, and if you use your brain properly, this is like a I'll say that like it's so easy. Coming to cutoff marks, these cutoff marks are not mentioned, But make sure that you just give your best so that even if the cutoff is so higher, you would be like, you know, getting shortlisted. And like how to attend the exam is, you know, I would suggest you to start with easier topics. I mean, easier topics, either easier sections or the section in which you are so perfect at. You feel like confident at. I'm not sure if you have that section-wise timer, as I said you, but if you have it, then you should just go the section-wise only. But if you don't have it, make sure that you choose a section where you're so confident in, so that you won't struck in between and you don't waste like most of the time in there. And don't ever waste your time in a single question. If you are not confident about the answer, you can actually put it for a review and you can just later go on to that question again. So don't ever waste the time on a single question. If you're not unsure, like, you can just, like, as we don't have negative marking at end, you can just, like, you know, I don't prefer saying that, but, like, you know, we can't do anything, right? If you're not sure of the answer, just check, like, you know, the way which actually suits the question more and just, like, opt it. Okay, and coming to the answering the questions, let's say some equation. I'm just giving an example equation. So you have the four options. So you can just like apply some option in that particular equation and find it. If it is actually matches, then you can just like go with it. But don't ever do everything like this. Just follow this trick wherever it is applicable. Just read the question once or twice so that you will understand whether to do it option wise or you need to solve it from the starting. Okay, this is mainly for the math. And for the reasoning and all, try reading the question again and again. Okay, as I said, don't waste your time on it, but read the question so that you will understand it, and then you can just like, you know, use your ability to just like choose out the options from there. And as I said, like the last section, like the whatever the article writing, you don't have any marks for it, but don't take it like lightly. Just answer everything. First of all, I would like to suggest you that answer each and every question. Even if you don't know at the end, you can just answer it so that like there might be sometimes it might get correct, right? So why don't we, like, why should we lose the marks, right? And coming to this article, just don't take it simply. Just give your best in that too. It's my opinion, because there might be chances that they might, I'm not sure also, because there are no proven results too, but they might consider that too. So don't ever leave it unattempted. Please do attempt everything. And coming to my tips and tricks that I suggest is that I did not, like, there are no shortcuts for that, like, you know, success, to be honest. You just need to hard work. As you don't have much time, because like the exam is coming like in the 4 days to 3 to 4 days, I would suggest you to revise the topics, like what all the questions. You can just like find the last year questions, and like, you know, there are many more videos on YouTube if you want. Actually, in those videos they actually mention each and every question very clearly. So what I suggest you is that just recap the like, you know, I hope you have already completed your preparation. Maybe if you're not, like, don't worry, just like give an attempt so that you will understand, right? So don't worry about it, and just like try to attempt it very, you know, with your full attempt, like efforts. Okay, just don't like to take it lightly. And as I said, coming to the tricks and tips, I started with the aptitude, like preparing with the aptitude. I actually love math, so I started with it. Like, you have like some easy questions. So everyone who got shortlisted, I guess you just got to know when is your exam, what is the exam center. I have this information that like some of the students, like how like, you know, have their exam on 4th of November in Malla Reddy University. And just do comment if, like, you know, when is your exam and like where is the place. So don't ever panic, okay? I suggest you just to be prepared, and just be prepared in such a way that even if you just like get shortlisted in written exam, the interview would also be like right next day. Like for us, like the exam, this written exam was conducted like for 3 days, and the very next day, like on the third day evening, we got the shortlisted names, and the very next day we got the interview. So don't ever take it lightly. Just prepare. Like if you have time, it's better to prepare for the interview. Like if you're already ready with this, you know, preparation of written test, you can just like prepare one day for the interview and remaining 2 days again to like recalling everything whatever you have prepared for the written exam. And if you need a video on how I cleared and how I prepared for an interview in a single day, just like do comment interview, so that I will be making a video soon after this, so that you won't be missing any important information that actually you need to know before attending the interview. Okay, so last minute tips, there are nothing like that, but the thing is that you just need to be confident, don't get tensed, like whatever you know you answer, whatever you don't know we'll just see that later. Okay, just give your best and keep in mind like time would be running, so just keep that in mind and do write the exam. As I said, if you're stuck somewhere, you just like keep it for a review, or else you'll forget again. Keep it for a review and then go to the next questions. And I would suggest if there is enough section wise timer, pick the section like which you're perfect at, as I said you before, and which you are confident that you can do it in like minutes, so that you can complete that section faster and you can use this time on the sections where you don't you're not so aware of, or you're just like frightened off or something like that. And lastly, have a good sleep on the night like before the exam, so that you won't be, you know, we will feel something like that, you know, when you write an exam, so don't ever feel that. So please do take enough rest before the exam, and like you reach the exam center at least before, you know, make sure you reach it before at least half an hour. Maybe actually they actually ask you to report 1 hour before, so try to do that, so that you won't be missing anything, or you won't be like, you know, in a hurry and all, because in a hurry like sometimes we do, like we forget answers too. It happens with me, I don't know what about you. So try to do these things, carry a pen, maybe carrying a pen, like, you know, they will give you the rough sheets, you don't need to carry any of the rough sheets, so you will just get a mail, you can just take a like, you know, print out of that mail, they'll ask for it actually. And coming to the mobile phones, bags and all, if you carry, that's okay, they will, you can just like keep it there before writing exam. We just put our bags and phones over there in the room and we started writing exams, and the exam would be in the computer. Make sure that you just change your password and like you remember your username of that particular task, you know, you will be registering to the task, right? You remember the username and password, because you don't have your phone after you like, you know, keep the phone there, so that's your reason. Just like remember it, reset the password and remember it, so that you can log in into the computer system. There will be the invigilators, they will be saying when to log in, you can just log in and exact time, like, you know, like let's say the exam starts at 11 a.m. the exam, like the login button, like whatever login button actually activates exactly at 11 a.m. so that you can just start. Don't waste a single minute, every minute is very very important. And as I said you before in my previous video, the whole Telangana people will be writing this exam, so make sure that you stand out and you will be qualifying this exam. Okay, and all the best guys, just like do prepare well. These are the, like, you know, these last 2 to 3 days are very crucial, and you know how the people are outside, there are a lot of students who got graduated but they're still searching for the job. So I suggest you to utilize this opportunity. If you actually dreamt of these MNCs like Infosys, TCS and all, be prepared, write the exam very well, give your best, and the results will see it, no problem. If you work hard, they come like automatically, you don't need to worry about it. So once again, all the best guys. If you need a video for an interview, just comment down interview, so that I'll make you a video for interview, and it will be useful for you too if you are not aware of what to or like how to attend the interview and all. Even it's my first interview and I cracked it. So nothing is so hard, you just need to be confident and you just need to work hard on it. Okay guys, that's it for this video, see you in the next video, take care and all the best for your exam. Bye-bye.